the U.S. Open, the World Series, the NBA Finals, the Super Bowl, the College Football Playoffs, the World Alpine Ski Championships, NASCAR on Fox, NASCAR on NBC. The one constant behind all of these signature events, Game Creek Video. On January 29th, 1991, Pat Sullivan resigned from his 31-year association with the New England Patriots. Over the next couple of years, he pursued his interest in mobile television production, and in 1993, invested in two TV trucks known as Gemini and Discovery. Pat wanted to include his family in naming the new company. They chose a name that honored their favorite part of Vail's ski area, and Game Creek Video was born. The company was established in Youngstown, Ohio, but soon Pat decided to move it to Windham, New Hampshire because of its business-friendly environment. After a short time in Windham, the company moved to Amherst, New Hampshire, and again in 2002 to its current location in Hudson. Pat was immersed in all aspects of the business, sales, operation, even being on site, helping out in any way he could. For example, flying from Nebraska to Missouri and back to get a replacement camera lens just in time to make air. In 1997, Game Creek built Northstar. This was its first ground-up mobile unit. Northstar was a hit from day one. It was a very advanced truck for its time, featuring digital and analog video routers, Ikigami cameras, and many other cutting-edge technologies, including 30 DPS frame sinks. Game Creek's growth continued in 1999 with the digital conversion of the original Discovery and the building of another next-generation truck known as Intrepid. The first to be integrated in-house. Named after an America's Cup sailing ship, Intrepid helped Game Creek solidify ties with what would turn out to be one of its major clients, ESPN. The family aspect of Game Creek continued to be important to Pat. The Sullivans hosted Christmas for many years until the company gathering finally outgrew their home in West Newton, Mass. In 2002, the event moved south and became Christmas on the Cape, held during the slower time of summer when more people could attend. At the turn of the century, Game Creek was busy televising the Millennium celebrations in Boston and prepping for the future. Olympic came into existence with the retirement of Gemini, and a truck known as Red was purchased from Unitel. Later that year, ESPN would decide to get out of the mobile television truck business and agreed to sell a partially completed mobile unit to Game Creek. Renamed Eagle, it became the keystone to a new relationship with the newly formed Yankees Entertainment Sports Network, known as YES. In 2002, Game Creek advanced the state of the art yet again. Southern Cross, the last standard definition truck to be built by the company. This was the first router-centric truck designed to do large-scale live broadcast events back-to-back without the need for excessive patching. It was an instant success and set the standard and general design concept for all future Game Creek mobile units. Southern Cross would go on to broadcast the World Series from Fox and entertainment events like Rolling Stones 40 Licks Tour and opening night of Celine Dion's show in Las Vegas. In late 2003 and early 2004, new contracts were signed and Game Creek would start the process of building two identical HD mobile units, Patriot and Yankee Clipper. These trucks were designed to do large-scale HD events for ESPN and the YES Network. It was during these builds that Game Creek began working with Sony to develop a new camera, the Sony 1500. In 2005, Game Creek was awarded the Fox, NFL, and NASCAR contracts, which included the production of the Daytona 500, NFL on Fox, and multiple Super Bowls. This was a pivotal moment which continued to push Game Creek across many milestones. The trucks built to support the Fox contract became known as FX A, B, C, D, and the Hollywood Hotel. This five-truck fleet was built to handle the largest televised events in the world, sporting the pace of video router and fiber interconnect system that Game Creek has become known for. Several technical achievement Emmys have since been awarded to the crews of the FX trucks. Also in 2005, Game Creek Video delved into the political arena with the inauguration of George W. Bush. The company has gone on to televise every presidential inauguration since. During 2006, Intrepid was rebuilt as an HD truck, and a contract was negotiated with Madison Square Garden Network. 2007 saw Game Creek's first broadcast of the Daytona 500, a massive undertaking where the truck spent almost 4 weeks on site, ending in a fiery finish that will be replayed for years to come. In 2008, Game Creek got its first chance to televise the Super Bowl in Phoenix, Arizona, which at the time set the record with 111 million viewers. After a flawless performance, the fleet of trucks had to be packed up immediately for the cross-country trek to the Daytona 500. A daunting challenge, but one that Game Creek's team met without fail. Game Creek continued to add clients such as Mid-Atlantic Sports Network and Comcast New England. And trucks continued to be built, including Northstar and Liberty. Then in the midst of these golden years, disaster struck. On April 9th, 2009, the 8-month-old Liberty A was en route to Orlando when it was engulfed in flames due to a fire in the wheel well. Thankfully, no one was hurt, but the truck was deemed a complete loss. In a show of strength and resilience, Game Creek rallied and built Liberty 2 within 4 months to be ready for the college football season, upholding its contract with ESPN. What could have been a terrible turn of events for Game Creek ended up being a fantastic collaboration between their insurance company, their bank, ESPN, and of course the staff that never gave up hope. Ever moving forward, the company continued to advance technology by building Dynasty for the YES Network and moving to Evert's embedded routing. In 2010, multiple trucks were supplied for the Vancouver Olympics for CBC and NBC. In the winter of 2011, Game Creek televised its second Super Bowl in icy Dallas, Texas, before then heading to the sunshine of Florida and the Daytona 500. More contracts were picked up with AT&T, the NFL Network, Major League Baseball, spurring on the production of several more new trucks: Glory, Pride, Apollo, and Gemini. Two contracts in particular had always been elusive, Nesson and SNY. But in 2013, Game Creek broke through the competition and partnered with both of them. In the years 2014 and 15, the company was full steam ahead. It televised its third Super Bowl and built many trucks from the ground up. Riverhawk, Discovery, Spirit, Maverick, Peacock One, and of course Encore, which was designed specifically for the U.S. Open, the largest event ever televised at the time. Other accomplishments during these years were sideways audio rooms, IP routing, and picking up NASCAR for NBC. And most notably, Pat Sullivan being inducted into the Sports Broadcasting Hall of Fame.
So, to all of my families, I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I'm honored and humbled to be accepting this award on your behalf. Each and every one of you should be up here next to me, as you have been from the day we started this incredible journey 23 years ago. Thank you.
2014 brought about another meaningful moment for Pat. As of that year, all three of his sons, Garrett, Kyle, and Terrence, had officially joined the company. 2016 would bring about the creation of Nitro, Madison, and Chesapeake. These would be for clients such as the National Hot Rod Association, Madison Square Garden, and the Mid-Atlantic Sports Network. This year would also mark the first season of Major League Baseball's Showcase in 4K, this earning the coveted George Wenzel Technical Achievement Emmy Award. In addition, Pat was once again honored by receiving the New Hampshire High-Tech Entrepreneur of the Year Award. The following year, Game Creek televised its fourth Super Bowl in Houston. The Patriots won. The company crossed the border for an NFL game in Mexico City. The Patriots won again. Yogi was built as the third truck for the YES Network, and new contracts were formed with NBC Sports, Mid-Atlantic Sports Network, and the NHL. And then on August 31st, a new milestone was reached. For the first time in company history, every single Game Creek truck was busy. 2018 saw the launch of 79, an IP-based truck designed for ESPN, doing a string of events each year, including NBA, NBA Finals, ABC College Primetime Football, and the College Football Playoffs. Two major firsts marked this year for the company: floating a truck to the Olympics in South Korea for NBC, and the NCAA Final Four for CBS. Game Creek continues to lead the industry in technology and superior professional service, but at its heart, it's the people who make it all possible. Over the past 25 years, the company has grown to more than 150 employees, or more accurately, family members.
Happy birthday, Game Creek!
Happy 25th to Game Creek Video.
Happy 25, Pat.
Happy birthday, Game Creek.
Happy 25th anniversary, Game Creek.
Each and every person plays a critical role in the success and the development of the company every day. From the engineers who ensure that the client has the highest quality broadcast possible, to the drivers who ensure that the mobile units arrive safe, clean, and on schedule to every show, to the office staff who ties it all together.
Happy birthday, Game Creek.
Happy birthday, Game Creek.
Game Creek, happy 25th, the silver anniversary. Cheers to all of you.
From Patriot, the oldest truck in the fleet, from the youngest guys in the company,
happy 25th, Game Creek.
It is the team's enthusiasm, hard work, dedication, and care for each other that have enabled Game Creek to reach this special milestone while building and carrying the reputation as the very best in the industry.
Pat, Lynn, and Sullivan, thank you very much. Happy 25th anniversary, Game Creek Video.
Thanks again, Buzz, from all of us. Happy anniversary, Game Creek.
Happy anniversary, Game Creek Video, from the mighty.
Happy 25th, Game Creek Video.
As Game Creek Video marks its 25th anniversary, it celebrates everything it has achieved with its entire family and eagerly looks to the future to see what the next 25 years will bring.